Hello and welcome, class. Welcome to another day of financial mastery and kingdom authority. My name is Denzel Rodriguez. If you're here for the first time, like this video, subscribe, watch some of my previous content, really get into the mix here. We're going to be talking about velocity banking, kingdom authority, and infinite banking, really mastering your personal finances so that you can create a legacy that will last forever. Today's topic is all about cash flow. You got to master the cash flow. You got to get the cash flow. Cash flow is the most important tool in velocity banking. I used to think it was the line of credit. I used to think it was your good credit score. I used to think it was the strategy itself. No. Nothing works without cash flow. See, you could have bad credit. You could have a small line of credit, a high interest rate on a line of credit. You could have all the debt in the world. But if you got cash flow, we can make some progress. We can make some damage. I decided to once again throw my numbers on the board. You know, I do this like once a month. I'll make a video where I put my numbers on the board and really bring you up to speed, show you where I'm at, show you the growth so you can really document and you can track the progress. You can track my progress and you can compare it to what you're doing and see where are the holes. You see, what are you missing? What am I doing that you're not, that you should be doing, right? That you should be implementing. So we're going to be focusing on cash flow. I'm going to focus in this video. I'm going to map out the plan. I'm going to show you how I create the plan to cash flow, what it looks like, and then I'll make another video where we actually put the plan in action. Let's direct our attention to the board. Here we have, it's April 2019. This is the amount of revenue that I brought in for the month of April, $13K. Here are my expenses, $3,371.29. Here is debt, zero. Okay, we're debt free. Cash flow is minus the two, $9,628.71. We have our debt tool, line of credit for $10,000. Here is leveraged debt, or AKA good debt. I've got three credit cards that I use both on personal and the business side, where I run nearly every single expense from this number right here. You're gonna see it down here. So to give you an idea, it's April 2019. We're approaching, it's April 30th as I record this video. So for January, February, March, and April, if my expenses were this, then you can pretty much add these three numbers up and you can make the assumption that, okay, from January to towards the end of April, I've basically been running all my expenses through my other debt tools, my leverage debt. Reason why I call it leverage debt is zero interest. It's got cashback rewards in all of them. And I have a long intro period on every single one of them. Nice, good space. So it's 9 months from April. Okay, so 9 months from today, April, and then 15 months from April, and then 6 months on the Discover. That's the shortest one. But still, very nice long window period. I was able to throw a good 4 months of expenses onto these debt tools. And I will explain why that is, why I did that. Okay, and here's my line of credit, $10K, zero balance. And then here is all the cash flow. It's still there, right, for the month of April. All there. Now, why is cash flow so important? Cash flow is going to allow me to create substantial amount of wealth. It's going to allow me to really discipline myself as well. And this is one thing that I want to stress on, being a millennial. So for all my millennial viewers, young people in their late 20s, early 20s, early teens, listen, do not spend your money on stupid things. And for my adults in my 40s and 50s, driving the damn Mercedes with a $900, $800 monthly payment. Dude, instead of the Mercedes, I mean, just drive a Lexus and have a half a payment. Who do you got to impress, right? Who do you have to impress? If you can't buy that car two times, you've got no business buying it in the first place. Okay, that's my whole thing. And to really back up why you should be preserving your cash flow, really maximizing the potential of it, is because Uncle G, okay, Grant Cardone, I went through his little wealth creation formula. He's got a wealth creation course. Really, really good. Very cheap, by the way. He's like giving this stuff away for like 50% off, 90% off. So I bought one of his programs. Actually, I bought a live webinar and it came with that program, Wealth Creation Formula. One of the first things he says to do, right, is 10X, right? 10X your income. After you 10X your income, he literally says to save it all. Save it all, the cash flow, all right? So on the board here, we're going to design a savings plan, okay, to store this money safely, protect it, and not waste any of it. We don't want to lose any of our money. Here is the game plan. Okay, this is the game plan that I have. 6 months of prep work. So I've been creating this plan for myself that I also do for my clients when we're doing velocity banking, infinite banking, and kingdom authority, when we're trying to establish that. Where that first 6 months of working with me is crucial to the success of our strategy, right? So I'm just gonna, you know, so I'm displaying my work as well because it's important for me to actually do what I tell you to do, right? We gotta, you know, we have to be in agreement together. So 6 months of pre-work to establish a savings plan to save it all. The cash flow, save it all, right? How are we going to do that? How can I leverage velocity banking, kingdom authority to get me to the level that I want to get to? So we're approaching the fifth month, right? End of April. So I'm really, really close to actually putting my plan together. The goal is to have a policy in force by June of 2019, okay? If I do this by June of 2019, my birthday is on January 4th. So by me getting a policy before I'm 23 and a half, I'll be able to save my age at 23, even though I'll be turning 24, right? So that's another little key factor in there that's gonna save me a couple dollars, not a whole lot, but it's definitely gonna save me some money when we're acquiring a life insurance policy for the infinite banking concept, right? Because that tool right there is going to allow me to what? Save it all and not lose any of my money, right? Preserve it, grow it. The goal is to reach $100,000 in cash before I invest in something outside of myself, outside of my own expertise. So from zero to 100,000, in the meantime, I will be 10Xing the income and investing in myself day in and day out, day in and day out. And I'm gonna break down how I divvy out the numbers, how I spread out the numbers, okay? So that's the game plan. Here's the strategy. We have our velocity banking triangle. The goal, we're trying to create a financial flow. On the left side of the triangle, we have our income. This $13,000 comes in, lands in the business checking account or the personal account. Either one. For me, it's going in the, everything goes into the business checking account, and then I pay myself money. All right. On this side, we have the line of credit for $10,000. It's at a 15.99% interest rate. My goal over the next year is to increase that. I will increase that line of credit. I'm gonna do a couple moves first, and then I'm going to approach my credit union and say, hey, can you give me 20 G's Thank you. Have a nice day. The strategy is, since I have cash flow on a monthly basis that matches what my credit limit is on my line of credit, I'm okay with pulling out the whole amount. And I'm gonna do it in such a way that I'm gonna pull out the whole amount and still pay nothing in interest. I'm gonna show you how. So I'm gonna take this 10K, right? The bank's 10K, 10,000 from the bank. I still got my 13 here. Taking 10K from here, I'm gonna establish that life insurance policy on a 23-year-old by June of 2019. The amount that I'm going to fund the policy is going to be based off 40% of my cash flow and my total annual expenses in a year. And I'll explain why. Here are the numbers right here. My annual expenses, if you take that expense number, you times it by 12, you'll get this number. If you take 40% of that number, you times it by 12, you're gonna get 46,000. Add those two numbers up, you're gonna get this number right here. I'm gonna create a savings plan that allows me to save money, but also pay my bills, not lose anything, not lose any of my money, and also keep 100% of my cash flow, which goes back to the point of saving it all properly. So my MEC in a life insurance policy is the absolute max amount of money that I can put into a policy in any given year. 86,000, that's the number I want to set it to. The amount that I want to fund my policy is going to be $40,000. The reason why it's $40,000 is based off the first year of me doing velocity banking on my policy to keep all my cash flow. If I take 10,000 out of the policy, right? That's called my chunk. Chunk it into the policy. The very next move, my income, the 13K, it's going to get deposited into the line of credit. So right here, 10K out, 10K in. Same day. If I do it on the same day, my friend, I will pay nothing in interest. I can take the money out, put it right back in. Boom. Pay nothing in interest. Let the money sit there, and I'll still have about 3K left over right here in the checking account. Now, so I got 3K left there. No balance owed on the line of credit. We've got 10K in the policy. The first thing that happens is money goes into two places, premiums and cash value. I will determine my premium is based off my total MEC. All right. I want my cost of my policy to be no more than 10 to 15% of what I'm putting in. So I say that I'm putting in 40,000, right? Four chunks in a year, and I'm gonna lay out exactly how I got that number. But four chunks of 10K in a year, that's what I'm saying that I'm gonna put into the policy, but I actually have a MEC that's more than double that amount. So as long as I can keep my premiums anywhere from 10 to 15%, I will be happy. That's gonna minimize my cost. It's gonna maximize my cash value. In addition to the 10K that I'm throwing into the policy initially, the bank's money is going to satisfy that premium for the year. And I have an additional 6,000 cash on hand. So now I've got a total that's gonna be going into that policy about 16K to really start it off. It's gonna be like about 16K is gonna start it off. I have the ability to put in more money when I want, as I choose, at leisure, throughout the year, no problems, no issues, because I have a properly designed policy. So I'm allowed to put in more money as I please. So now that I've given you a synopsis, we know the numbers here, that's the goal that we wanna hit. We know that we need to put in a certain amount initially so that there's this initial cash flow to borrow from, this cash value, which is my expenses. It's money that I'm already going to spend, right? So rather than using my cash flow to fund it, I'm using the bank's money first, and then I'm calculating expenses that I'm already going to pay, and I'm just borrowing against it on a month-to-month basis. And then the income sits in the line of credit, and I don't have to pull money out of the line of credit. I don't have to pull money out of the line of credit. Why do I need to pull money out of the line of credit if I pulled it from here to pay bills? The way I mapped it out for myself to be really, you know, just conservative is every 3 months, I'm gonna chunk 10,000. So that'll be a total of 40. That's what I said I'm going to fund, but I'm actually putting in more. The reason why I say a lower number so I can keep my cost of premiums down and still have a high MEC. The MEC is that high because I'm preserving 40% of the cash flow and all of my expenses. But understand that this money right here will be non-affected, okay? It'll be non-affected by any cost. That 46, I move it from my checking account or my savings account over a 12-month period, and I put it in here. And this policy will function as my savings account, okay? That's what it'll function as. It'll also function as a means to pay bills. I'm gonna use that money over a year's time period to also do my tithe, tax, and emergencies. So I have, this is my emergency fund, this is my savings account, this is my means for paying expenses that are consistent, and this is my means for preserving cash flow, saving all of it, not losing any of it. Very powerful. So every 3 months, I'm gonna be chunking that 10K in. In between those 3 months, we're borrowing against the policy. We have plenty of cash value available to do so. As I keep making income, it lands right here. It's gonna sit there, it's gonna grow. All right, I keep doing 13 a month, or I grow it 15 and 18 and 20, and I keep going. The other 60% of my cash flow, which is this number right here, 69,000. Take that number, times it by the 60, times it by 12, that's what you get. Instead of me taking this cash flow and being a clown and wasting money on fast cars and fancy restaurants, taking girlfriend out every single week to fancy restaurants, if I just humble myself, if I act like I don't make that, right? If I literally just do that, live off that amount, which is what? My expenses. Act like I have no cash flow, because what does Uncle G says to do? What does Uncle G say to do? Save it all. Well, here's how I'm gonna save all my money. Is I'm putting a nice chunk into my policy. I'm letting that grow. And then I'm also stuffing a good portion of that money into investing in myself and focusing on more income streams. And I keep acting like the money ain't there. And I can put it in real estate, in my business, creating partnerships, right? If you focus on growth rather than temporary pleasures, you will live a life of growth and have an extraordinary life of pleasure. But see, if you tackle temporary pleasures for short-term growth, then you'll live a temporary life of pleasure with a temporary life of growth. So my whole thing to you is, by looking at this concept here, looking at this strategy, I'm sure it's gonna confuse some people, right? Even I'm learning it. Even I'm trying to put it together. That's why I'm doing 6 months of prep work, putting it together for myself. And then I also do this for my clients. This is why I try to work your way up, right? Let's become debt free. Let's increase cash flow. Let's build your income. Let's minimize expenses. Let's create leveraged debt. Let's create more good debt. All right. Let's map out your financial life. Let's create a business, partnerships, real estate, Invest in yourself. Focus on multiple streams of income. Watch more videos. Watch my content, right? So this is the first beginning step of the plan and why cash flow is so important. Hope this helps. I'm going to make a follow-up video to this, really diving into the numbers a little bit further and going over how we continue to grow our savings and for how long are we going to grow those savings before actually making big investments in different avenues, different markets, industries, such on and such on. So my name is Denzel. Have a blessed day. Talk to you soon.